Kelly, one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. Chemists often need or are given the composition of a compound by mass percent. Today, we will learn how to calculate mass percent two different ways. Percent composition, or mass percent, is the percent by mass of a given element in a compound. It is often used by chemists to determine the formula of an unknown sample after chemical analysis. The mass percent of a compound is calculated by dividing the mass of the element by the mass of the compound multiplied by 100. The sum of each element's mass percent equals 100%. Note that masses in chemistry are usually given in grams. However, for this formula, it is only necessary that both masses have the same units. There are two common methods by which mass percent is calculated. The first by having known masses, and the second by using the formula of the compound. Let's do an example to illustrate how to use given information to find mass percent. A 63.2-gram sample of water decomposes to produce only hydrogen and oxygen gases. 7.1 grams of hydrogen gas is formed. What is the mass percent of hydrogen in water? What is the mass percent of oxygen in water? And what mass of oxygen was produced? For the first part, we are given that the mass of water is 63.2 grams, and the mass of hydrogen gas produced is 7.1 grams. Using the mass percent formula, we divide the mass of hydrogen by that of water, which is 7.1 grams, over 63.2 grams. After multiplying by 100%, we find 11.2%. For part B, we were not given the mass of oxygen, so it feels as though we don't have enough information. However, we know the process produced only hydrogen and oxygen. Therefore, we know that the percent of hydrogen plus that of oxygen equals 100%. Subtracting the mass percent of oxygen is 88.8%. Finally, the mass of oxygen can be found using the mass percent formula. Percent of oxygen equals mass of oxygen divided by mass of water times 100%. Using 88.8% oxygen and 63.2 grams water, we calculate 56.1 grams of oxygen. Double-checking, the sum of 56.1 and 7.1 grams equals 63.2 grams, the mass of water. Sometimes we only have a chemical formula. While we haven't been given masses to put in our formula, we can find the percent composition of each element. Calculate the mass percent of each element in magnesium chloride. First, we need the chemical formula. Remembering ionic naming, magnesium chloride has the chemical formula MgCl2 because magnesium has a positive 2 charge and each chloride has a negative 1 charge. Since we have the chemical formula, we can base the mass percent calculations on the assumption that we have 1 mole of magnesium chloride. We need to calculate the molar mass of magnesium chloride. 1 mole of magnesium has an atomic mass of 24.30 grams per mole, while the two chlorides each have an atomic mass of 35.45 grams per mole. Adding these together will get a total of 95.20 grams per mole. Since we are assuming that we have 1 mole, the sample mass is 95.20 grams. To find the mass percent of magnesium, we need the mass of magnesium in 1 mole of magnesium chloride. Since there is one magnesium atom per formula unit, the mass of magnesium is equal to its atomic mass, or 24.3 grams. Now we can use our mass percent formula, which is mass of magnesium divided by mass of magnesium chloride multiplied by 100%. Substituting our masses, we divide 24.30 by 95.20. The mass percent of magnesium is 25.53%. We will use the same approach for chlorine. However, in this case, there are two chloride ions per formula unit. We have 2 moles of chloride per mole of magnesium chloride. Therefore, 2 times 35.45 grams per mole equals 70.90 grams of chloride. Using the mass percent formula, we divide the mass of chloride by the mass of magnesium chloride times 100%. This equals 74.47%. Since we know the identity of the compound and that it contains only these two elements, we can check our calculations. In this case, 25.53 plus 74.47 equals 100%. Thanks for stopping by for this introduction to percent composition of compounds. For more information on this and other topics, come visit us at Chegg to speak with one of our subject matter experts.